President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. orders the Agriculture Department to relax the importation process of agricultural products as well as the removal of non-tariff barriers. This as the president moves to boost local supply and address rising commodity prices in the country. Non-tariff barriers include quotas, import licensing systems, regulations, and red tape that restrict or delay the entry of imports. The Sugar Regulatory Administration was also ordered to allow more traders to participate in its import program. A surveillance team was also created to monitor the import and distribution of agricultural imports and prevent rice manipulation. The team will include members from the Departments of Agriculture, Finance, Interior and Local Government, and the Philippine National Police, among others. The World Bank begins today a three-week review of two agriculture projects it is co-funding in the Philippines. The Agriculture Department says the three-week mission will assess the implementation of initiatives under the Philippine Rural Development Project. It will also look into the agency's financial management and procurement, among others. The two projects are in Visayas and Mindanao. These aim to provide financial and infrastructure support to agriculture and fishery-related enterprises, as well as establish climate resilience rural infrastructure. The Philippine government seeks to convert to tourism assets several buildings at the Presidential Palace Complex in Manila. President Marcos spoke with the initiative in a video blog over the weekend. He said the renovations will help provide venues for meetings by foreign investors and visitors in the Philippines. The buildings up for renovation include the Goldenberg and La Peral mansions. The palace did not say how much the government is spending for the initiative.
Mahalaga na ang ating bisita, eh, pakiramdam naman nila, eh, very welcome sila dito. Para naman maging mas matibay ang ating pagsasama, ang ating mga agreement, ang ating mga partnerships sa iba't ibang bansa.
Securities and Exchange Commission files a criminal complaint against the MFT Group led by CEO Maria Francesca Tan, Foundry Ventures and its officers and agents over alleged unauthorized solicitation of investments. Based on complaints, the group had solicited investments supposedly for startup companies in exchange for a guaranteed return ranging from 12 to 18% per annum. The group had also allegedly issued post-dated checks that were never paid. Now, the filing of criminal cases came, or charges, after the SEC, or SEC, issued a cease and desist order in January directing all MFT Group executives to stop their unregistered investment solicitation activities. Now, here's a quick look at the flash business headlines from overseas. Ukraine hails the long-awaited approval of U.S. aid into Kyiv. American lawmakers on Saturday passed a $95 billion legislative package providing security assistance to Ukraine, Israel, and Taiwan. The legislation will likely make it to U.S. President Joe Biden's desk this week after the Democratic majority Senate takes up the package on Tuesday. Painful shortages in weapons and manpower have pushed Ukraine's fighting forces close to a breaking point, raising the risk of a Russian breakthrough. Meanwhile, TikTok reportedly preparing to remove a key executive responsible for convincing the U.S. government that the company is addressing national security concerns about its connections to China. Bloomberg reports the company is eyeing to push out Erich Anderson, the U.S.-based general counsel for TikTok and its Chinese parent company ByteDance. The move comes after the U.S. House approved a bill requiring ByteDance to sell the popular social media app, or see it banned, in the U.S. In other news, layoffs under Swiss banking giant UBS will reportedly take place in five waves this year, starting in June. Now, UBS earlier announced its plan to cut costs by more than $10 billion following its takeover of Credit Suisse. As many as 35,000 jobs could be affected by the move. And finally, Tesla slashing the price of its full self-driving assistant software by a third in the U.S., from $12,000 to just $8,000. The CEO, Elon Musk, has struggled to achieve the goal of self-driving capability with the technology under growing regulatory and legal scrutiny. Tesla has also been cutting prices on its auto lineup in major markets like China as it grapples with falling sales and an intensifying price war for electric vehicles.